Good evening, all of you. And today the learning outcomes for this video session is explain how to use the 8085 simulator to enter and simulate an assembly language program. And we'll go through this. Yes. And this is the recap of the last class, where you have understand how to develop your program sequence through an application example. The application example is reading an input from a sensor and providing an actuating output at the output pin. The input is connected to port A and output is connected to port B. And the assembly language program for this application is, and initially we initialize the control word register of 8255 that we have discussed in our last class, and these are the instructions for those. So you have loaded a control word value in the control word register. The address of the control word register is 94H, which is indicated at the bottom of this slide here. And this 90 is the control word and which you are moving to accumulator, then you are transferring to the control word register. And in the next step, you are reading the input to understand whether the input has received a signal, and the input is connected to 0th pin of port A and you are reading it. And then comparing this input pin with the 01, because the input is connected to 0th pin. And if the value is 01, that means we can ensure that the data is present. So you are comparing the data with 01. Then you are checking for the 0 flag, and if 0 flag is set, we understand that input is received, else you are reading the data again. If the input is on, then you are moving a value 1 to C register, so that in the next step you are loading this value onto accumulator so that it will be transferred to port B. So that's the end of this program. Now the function, the objective of this today's session is how you are going to load this program in 8085 simulator and how you are going to run this. So let us see how you are going to do it. So I'm just copying this program. Now I am opening the 8085 simulator file here, and to install this file you need this Java installer also in your computer. So now I have opened this, and now I am just pasting the program which I have copied from the PowerPoint slide. So here is an icon called assemble, which you can, through which you can convert this mnemonics into assembly language program. So here you have registers, you can see the status of the registers, the stack pointers, memory pointer, and 16-bit registers. Here you can access the memory of your program, the data present in the program memory, and this is the data present in the IO, input output port addresses. Step by step is a button, it is used to run the program one instruction at a time to see what happens after the execution of one instruction, and this is running all the program simultaneously. Now I am giving assemble, and before that you have to make a point here. This again is a label which I have given from the PPT slide. Now I am assembling it. Now you see MDI A,90 is converted into proper exports. Out 94 is also converted into proper export. Whereas in 80, in that place you see your instruction NOP, and here there is a cross mark, and here error at line number 3. So we understand that if there is an error in your mnemonics, you'll get the NOP in India Assembly Language Program. So then how to enter this label, just give colon, here maybe one space is sufficient. Now you assemble this program. Now you see your program is properly assembled with the labels in this instruction. Now the data is given to 80, so let us load your data. So as the port A pin is connected to the input is connected to 0th pin of port A, let us assume the input is on. So we give 01. So if the data is 01, that means input is on. So if input is on, you are outputting a data in 8A01. So to execute this program, you have to get your data here 01 in 8A. So now execute this. Now you see 8A has a data 01. So this is how you assemble and execute the program. Coming back to the PPT. So this is the program which we understood how to enter and simulate. Now we have some assessment questions also. How to convert mnemonics into ALP in simulated software? Using which button? Yes, assemble button. Then how to enter the label in the mnemonics, that is the label for the looping instructions. So very simple, label followed by colon. Why step by step button is used? To execute one instruction at a time and understand what happens. So that's the end of this session. In the next class, in our class, we'll be dealing how to write your program and simulate it in the 8085 simulator.